Hello everyone. I'm pretty sure if I haven't had the chance to meet you or, you know, say hello to you today, if you don't know who I am, my name is Wesley Robinson. I'm Shantae's boyfriend, knight in shining armor, whatever good nickname you want to throw out there for me. I just want to take this time and opportunity to thank everybody for, you know, coming out and sharing this celebration and experience with us, you know, that we're about to expect our first child. Babe, I know you're looking around like, you know, what is this guy up to again? But, you know, I just wanted to take this opportunity to open the doors and show everybody, you know, defining moments of our relationship that brought us and put us in this position today. We're about to expect our first child, and I am thrilled. I am excited. You know, I could not experience, you know, this journey with a better person. I could not find a better person to share this experience with, and I love you dearly. And I know you're probably wondering, like, am I shooting this from my car? I am, because the car is a, you know, it's just something to show that I'm gonna take you guys on a journey and show you significant moments in my relationship. So this is a, you know, a position to show you, you know, come ride with me and let me take you down the journey of Shantae and Wesley's love. I want to share that with everybody here and to show you, you know, how did we get here. And I hope you enjoy the ride. So let's go.
Station. This is the Georgia Aquarium. This is where we went on a date, and this is where we first held hands. It's a very significant moment in our relationship because, I mean, it wasn't just about us holding hands. It was just like, you know, I actually got a second date with you, which I thought I wasn't gonna get. But I still remember like it was yesterday that, you know, you were sitting outside waiting for me, and I had just left the parking garage, and I was just sitting there like, oh my gosh, she's like right over there. And we were like 50 yards away. You were sitting there waiting on me. I just couldn't believe, you know, how beautiful you look. You know, this is probably the second time I've saw you, you know, but, you know, you just looked stunning, you know, and it was just a very significant moment. We had a great time here. Remember the little dolphin show we had? I mean, it was hilarious. I mean, I enjoyed myself. I even wanted to take the dolphin home, but you wouldn't let me. But yeah, it was a very fun moment. I hope we can share more like that. So let's go to the next station and the next step in our relationship. Well, we got another location. We got the World of Coca-Cola, babe. I know you probably remember this better than anything. It was one of our fourth dates that we went on. And why is this place significant? Because it's right before the time that you went to Dubai, and this is the time I actually was gonna ask you to be my girlfriend. But I was a little too scared and a little too nervous. I didn't know if it was too early. I didn't know if it was the right time to do it. So I actually waited and to make you my girlfriend. That was the time that you had left to go to Dubai. But the whole time, you didn't notice, but every station that we went to at the Coke factory, I was trying to ask you. I was trying to, you know, find some way that I could just come out and just ask you, but I was a little too nervous. That's just the chicken in me. But it's a very significant moment that I'll never forget in my life. So let's go to the next station. Well, babe, I don't know if you can recognize this place right behind me, but it's the Uptown Comedy Corner here in Atlanta. It's the place that we had our first date. It was the day that we went to go see D.L. Hughley. And the funny thing about this story is that I wanted to take you out. Well, we were scheduled to go on a date on Friday, and I couldn't wait till Friday. You know, it was Tuesday, and I really wanted to take you out, and I was very excited that, you know, you were going to give me the opportunity for me to take you out. And plus, I had loved D.L. Hughley, but that's not the point. I wanted to, you know, I really wanted to take you out more importantly. But yeah, we came here, and you parked over here, and I was parked down this street, and that's when you drove, you know, you drove your mother's car, your mother's Honda here. And I was in line, and I was trying to be hard. And the funny thing is, like, I had a short sleeve shirt on, and it was like 40 degrees out, but I was trying to, you know, be, you know, strong and, you know, like, you know, show you the, you know, I'm a fit guy and stuff, but I was freezing my behind off, you know, just to look good for you. And you came across the parking lot, I still remember, you know, and you looked stunning, beautiful, gorgeous. I mean, anywhere that you can use, I mean, absolutely beautiful. And I couldn't believe, you know, that how beautiful you were. And you know, I was very excited, you know, to finally get to know you. You know, we talked over text messages and stuff, but that was the first interaction we had with each other. And another funny thing about that story, I know you remember we talked about it last week, was I went to order some food, and I ordered chicken tenders and fries. I didn't eat right after work, you know, so I was really, really hungry. I didn't have lunch that day. So when I had ordered some and I tried to get you some food, you were like, no, you ain't want nothing. But me, man, I tore them chicken tenders and fries up. And you were sitting there looking at me like, eh. I was like, please, Lord, I'm hungry. Let me just eat, you know, and please let me get a second date with her as well. Let me, that's a win-win. But, you know, overall, the night was funny. I don't remember nothing from that night. I don't remember no jokes or nothing. All I know is that I met a beautiful girl that I knew right at that moment that I met you and I hugged you for the first time. I knew that this is something special that I have and I need to hold on to it. You know, I knew right at that moment that, you know, that was really, really something, you know, you were really something special that I needed in my life. You know, once I got to know you, the night was over and everything. We talked on text messages, but getting that interaction and getting to sit down and talk with you and meet you for the first time, I knew that you were a special girl and you're still special to this day.
Well, that's the journey. It was only a few defining moments. I mean, we have hundreds of defining moments of our relationship that put us in this position, but those are a few that was close to my heart that I wanted to share with everybody. You know, just to say, you know, from all that, I just want to say, Shantae, I love you dearly, and like I said, I'm very excited to embark on this new journey with you. You know, I care about you a lot. You know, from the first day that I met you, I knew that I was gonna have, you know, someone very special. You know, someone that I would wanna, you know, take this on and, you know, ride it till the wheels fall off. We say that all the time because I truly mean it, you know. And I don't know if you know this, but my wheels are titanium. So I'm not looking for them to fall off, and I don't even need to look over to see if it's gonna fall off, because that's just, you know, how our love has been. You know, it's strong, and it's something that we're gonna, you know, cherish and love along with our baby boy, you know. So I love you dearly, babe. Really, what I'm trying to say is, what I want to say is, I can't say it, but I have three friends who probably can help me out. So, hey fellas, can you help me out?
Hey Shantae, we have a question. Will you marry Wesley?
Will you marry Wesley? Sun.
feels good to me. Yeah, my love and me. Well, smoother than a gentle breeze, flowing through my mind with ease, soft as can be. Well, when you're loving me. It seems to me we could sail together in and out of mystery. Well, I wanna be living for the love of you. All right now, all that I'm giving is for the love of you. You got me, girl.
That I